think body language is so cool because when you get really good at it, it's like reading someone's mind. You can see exactly what someone is thinking just by things that they're doing. And the best part is they have no idea that you know. That's what I think is so interesting about it, and that's why I've spent like a lot of time just learning about this subject. Because once you know what to look for, it gets really easy. Like in the past, it's shown me whether someone had interest in me, whether someone was lying to me. But basically, if they had anything they were hiding, you can just look for a couple key things and you know instantly. And so today, I wanted to do a video I've done in the past called Signs Guy Doesn't Like You, but instead of doing it like all the other videos that I've done, I wanted to make this more focused on body language. Not just the things that he's saying, but the things that he does, because, as we all know, actions speak louder than words. So if you're excited about this, if you enjoy learning about body language and you want me to talk more about this subject in the future, give this video a thumbs up down below so you can let me know. If this video gets 5,000 thumbs up, I will gladly make a part two to this video where we can get maybe a little bit more advanced and talk a little bit deeper on this topic. So sign number one, I'm gonna start off like really easy and like basic, and then we'll get like more advanced as the video goes on. But here's a really simple one. How often does he look at you? The thing is, guys are extremely visual creatures. When we're attracted to someone, okay, we can't help but look at them. But the thing is, when you're emotionally attracted to someone, they literally become physically more attractive. That doesn't even make sense when you really think about it. You're seeing the same thing, but your emotions determine whether it's attractive or not. You're looking at the same thing. I don't know. Maybe I'm just really easily amused. I just think that's so cool. But that's what happens. They become complete eye candy for you, and you can just look at them all day. Not because you want to be weird, but it's because when you look at them, you feel good. By the way, if you're a guy watching this video, hopefully you know not to just stare at women that you're attracted to, because in some cultures, that's considered weird, and in other cultures, that's considered sexual harassment. So I'm just warning you now. But the eyes never lie. Even if you're just friends with someone and you have like a class with them or whatever, you're going to look at them occasionally because you like them. Your eyes are showing what you're thinking about. And so if you're like in a class with someone, or if you're going out with a bunch of people and you want to know if the one person likes you, if they laugh, okay, if they don't look at you, they probably don't like you. And by probably, I mean I'm trying to be nice when I say he doesn't like you. If you're in a conversation with him one-on-one and he doesn't want to make direct eye contact with you, that doesn't just mean he doesn't like you. That means he's not comfortable with you. Or he's probably not comfortable with you, just for all the sensitive people out there. Another one, just because I feel like throwing in extra shit, if he doesn't watch your Snapchat or Instagram stories, probably doesn't like you. That's not a body language one, but it's still true. So those are some really good signs. Now, the next one is a really, really interesting one. And this has all to do with posture, how you present yourself when you're not even doing anything. If a guy slouches, his shoulders are rolled in, right? He's just not in a good mood. He's just like what is this? If his body language in general is closed off to you, he does not like you. When guys like a girl, there's just things that their caveman brain makes them do. Like, they're gonna sit up straight, their back is gonna be arched, okay? Their chest is gonna be out. And the psychology behind it is basically that guys, they want to appear bigger, they want to seem larger, because larger is more attractive. So question of the day, does size matter? Ladies, leave your answers in the comment section down below. Now, I mentioned this sign specifically about him having good body language, good posture, and things like that in the video about signs that a guy doesn't like you. Because if he's slouched, if he doesn't care, if his legs are crossed, he's not facing his legs towards you, he's all, you know, closed, he's like looking over the shoulder when he talks to you. If he's doing these things, he does not like you. He's not attracted to you. If when you talk to him, his nipples are not directly facing you, he's not into you. But the reason I say that in this video specifically is because a lot of the times, these signs, if you flip them around, like think about the opposite, usually it means like that's a sign that they do like you. Like for example, the last tip, if someone doesn't look at you a lot, they don't like you, but if they do look at you a lot, they probably do like you, right? It's the opposite. But if someone has closed off body language, even though that means they don't like you, just because they have good posture doesn't necessarily mean they do like you. Sometimes guys are just raised to have good body language, to have good posture, because that's just part of being a man, okay? And ladies, if you don't have good posture, if you slouch, if you're bad, is like a rainbow when you're walking, you gotta fix that. It doesn't matter if you're a guy or a girl. I know it even matters more as a guy. It is extremely attractive when a girl has good body language. I don't know if that's the same for girls, if it's like super attractive when a guy has good body language. If you want to let me know in the comments as well, feel free to do that. But I could call one of my friends right now and just ask them what they think about girls with good body language, and we would just go in on that conversation for like an hour. I'm gonna call my buddy right now because he's like a body language expert. Like, if I have questions about body language, I hit him up. I have a question for you.
Yeah, what's up?
Have we, or have we not, had in-depth discussions about how it is very attractive when girls have great body language.
Oh yeah, a lot.
We talk, right.
I don't think I put you on today.
I just kind of wanted you like to describe what is attractive body language versus unattractive body language.
It's when her back is straight and when you can just see the confidence, like the way that she walks and mm-hmm. arch in the back, the upper back especially has to be straight. And then you can tell the difference between like what's feminine and then obviously what's masculine.
I have like this one section where I kind of have like a rant about body language and like. Like, it's really unattractive when a girl has their shoulders slumped, like, you know, they're slouching, or their back isn't up straight. And literally, you were saying things that were, like, word for word what I just said in the video. And so, it was beautiful the way you put that.
That's fucking awesome.
I love it. So, yeah, sign number two. Good posture. I know this was, like, originally a video about signs a guy doesn't like you, and I kind of turned it into, like, you know, things you can do to, like, make someone attracted to you. But there you go. Now, number three, this one kind of relates back to something I said in tip number one, which is about smiling and laughing and just being in a good mood in general. This is more of like the emotional side of a guy's brain. When he's thinking and he's feeling things, he's gonna show them through things that he does. And so when a guy likes you, he's going to laugh at every terrible joke you say. He's gonna be smiling a lot. Again, he's gonna be looking at you a lot. When he laughs, he's going to look at you. Don't underestimate that one single tip, okay? If a guy laughs, see where he looks. Whoever he's looking at is the person he likes the most in the room. And guess what? If he's not laughing, if he's not smiling when he's in a room with you, if he's not looking at you when he laughs, if he doesn't just look like he's in a better mood when he's around you, odds are he doesn't like you. In fact, if you even want to go a step further, if he's ever in a bad mood when he's talking to you, that's just a big red flag. After you're dating someone, it's a different story because you guys are, you know, together and you're allowed to like open up and vent your frustrations and emotions to each other. But if you guys aren't together yet and he's like mad about something, like if you see him, he's in a bad mood and he's talking to you and he doesn't at least get in somewhat of a better mood over the course of the conversation, he probably doesn't like you. And there's two reasons for that. Number one, if he does like you, your very presence is going to make his entire day better. And number two, if he does like you, he doesn't want you to look at him as someone who is ever in a bad mood. He wants you to think he's just all hunky-dory and just everything's like rainbows and butterflies. In reality, it's not, but he doesn't want you to know that until, you know, he's already got you. And there are a couple exceptions to that rule, to be fair, but I'm not gonna get into that in like the course of this video. That's like outside the scope of this conversation. It's like some AttractAcademy shit right there, so we're not gonna talk about that now. Which, by the way, I was getting some questions that were people asking about how much it costs to enroll in AttractAcademy. Here's the deal. I want AttractAcademy to be what I wish college actually was. One of the things I hate about school is the fact that you pay for a class up front and then they don't care if you learn anything or if you like it or if you even go to the class. So I decided what I was going to do is make it so that you don't have to pay anything until after you go through the first week of classes. That way you can actually decide whether or not it's really for you and if you actually want to pay for it, because for me, this isn't about the money. The money is nice because YouTube hates me and they don't want to give me any money and I need to eat food. But that being said, I don't want to just take money from people if they don't actually like the product. So what I'm going to do is I'm giving it to everyone 1 week completely free. And if you love it, if you want to keep getting the new videos that I'm posting in there every single month, just stay subscribed. And if you don't like it for any reason, if it doesn't make you feel like you are genuinely becoming the most attractive and happiest version of yourself, let me know and I'm not going to charge you anything. So that's the offer that I'm doing for everyone who is watching this video currently. There's a limited number of spots at a given time just because I want to make sure it's actually good and I'm getting good reviews back before I start letting more people in. Does that make sense? So if this is something that interests you, click the link in the description down below and then you can get more information on the next page. Just a heads up though, if you put in all your information and the button doesn't work, that just means that all the spots are filled and I was too lazy to put up a new page. So yeah, feel free to check that out. But just remember, like, this is for people who are actually serious about going through like a real transformation in themselves. It's not for people who just want to stay the same and they're just bored and looking for entertainment. If you're looking for entertainment, I'm on YouTube. But if you're serious about becoming the most attractive version of yourself, the happiest version of yourself, if this is the kind of stuff that really interests you, then AttractAcademy is probably for you. Like, if you gave this video a thumbs up at the beginning because you were excited to learn about body language and nerdy things like that, then you would like AttractAcademy. If you didn't give this video a thumbs up at the beginning of this video, then odds are you won't like AttractAcademy. And so I just want to kind of give you a warning so I can maybe save you some time. Because it's not about having everyone. I don't care how many people join it. I just want to help people who are actually serious about it. Anyway, we've been talking about this way too long, so let's get back to the video. Now, the last sign that someone is not attracted to you has to do not only with you, but it has to do with your environment and the people around you. Because here's the thing, if you think a guy likes you, and maybe he does like you, but he also likes your friend, he doesn't really like you that much. Sometimes he'll be nice because you're friends with a girl who he does like, and you can misinterpret that being nice for him liking you, and that's not always the case. And I actually made an entire video, I gave like an entire method for how to tell whether or not a guy actually likes your friend. That's why I wanted to wait until the end to actually recommend that video, because if you made it all the way to the end and you're into like body language and all that nerdy stuff, then you're gonna definitely love that video, maybe even more than this one. So feel free to check that out if you're curious about it at all. But guys, I have a would you rather question that I want you to answer for me. Would you rather be amazing at reading other people's body language or amazing at hiding your own body language so no one else can read your body language and knowing like what you're thinking? But let me know, would you rather be offense or defense? Would you rather read other people or not have other people be able to read you? Let me know in the comments down below if you don't answer the question about whether or not size matters. But guys, if this is your first time ever watching one of my videos and you don't hate my face, feel free to subscribe because we make videos like this every single week. And guys, that's really all I've got to say on it. So thanks for watching and I'll see you guys next Monday. Peace.